said good day, sir!
Welcome everybody here to our last series of the night for the defense season 4, where there's $25,000 up for grabs courtesy of EIZO. We are here, of course, here in Group A, I believe. Oh no, Group... Double checking on my side, Group A. It's been a long day, guys. We've had ourselves some awesome games. Of course, a big thanks to Virtus Pro for blowing my mind early tonight. And of course, also a special thanks out to Hani for giving us something. We've never had him in the defense. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you should definitely check out game number 2 of the VP versus Fnatic game, which started us off today, which will be also rebroadcast at the conclusion of this best of 2 series. So let's jump ourselves inside the game. The draft has begun. Keita will be over on the Dire side, over on the Radiant side. Be Mousesports led by not their Mon Capitan. In fact, you'll notice right now that Sindarin is missing. He is absent. And Koitva is the man who is doing the draft. The man who has the wonderful name to pronounce that everybody loves pronouncing because it's just amazing. And for some reason also just add me.
5 seconds remaining.
He added me on Skype like a couple of moments ago. I'm like, hey, what's up, man? What's happening? He's, so I like, asked him, where is Sin? He's like, yeah, Sin sadly focusing on real life. And it is very sad, Sin. It's very sad. Don't understand how you have a real life on a Friday night when there's a defense game to play. Mousesports. They haven't had a great start at this competition already. In group A, they actually hold second position, tied across 3 places. With that last game that we had, where RoX.KIS like played out. Actually, I'm looking at that right now, and that looks incorrect. That actually looks incorrect, because RoX.KIS won 2 games up against Team Empire, and they've only been awarded 1 point. So I am assuming that something is awry with the RoX.KIS results, and I will have a bit of a look into that, because Keita took 2 games off RoX.KIS before. But basically, we are looking at a pretty much a tie between Na'Vi as well as Mousesports. They're both 1-1, so they both lost a game in the series. Remember, you must take the number 1 slot if you want to go straight into the upper bracket. That's the way this cookie doth crumble. So Keita Gaming, they've set a huge precedent for themselves already. The fact that they managed to go 2-0 up against RoX.KIS, and we'll see if they are capable right now of going further. Right now, they're having a lot of connection issues. I don't know if there's actually anything going on in the chat. There's just 3 of the Mousesports guys, in fact, DCing out. Fader, Black, as well as Pass, having some issues. So they just DC'd themselves out of the game for some unknown reason. Hopefully, they do come back. But Koitva continues with his draft. So starting up on the draft, we take out the Batrider, take out the Lone Druid. Wisp and Lifesteal being taken out by Koitva. So both teams don't really want to step out of the ordinary, especially when you look at the Mousesports lineup. We get the Nature's Prophet, we get the Magnus, we get the Gyro. We get Fadus Magnus, we get Black's Gyro, and we get Koitva's Nature's Prophet. Very much spread out. Zizzle will be the stand-in for this evening, so we'll see what role he'll take up. But a band that definitely has played with all these guys many, many times over again. The Germans all stick together. It's all good. So, Frigolite, Clockwork, Nyx, and Rubik for him. Nyx Assassin's actually the first time tonight we get to see him. And I say it's the first time tonight, and this is the 7th game this evening that we're broadcast out here on the channel, that we've seen the Nyx Assassin come out. Clockwork Goblin as well as Rubik, so we've got Slight Initiation. Interested to know what Nyx is really meant to be coupling up with here, like Rubik and Nyx together. Like, looks good, but Clockwork Goblin as well, so we get a safe lane kind of player. If they're expecting a long lane kind of hero, you wouldn't want to put a Nature's Prophet up against a Clockwork Goblin, not unless the Clockwork has a little bit of extra support, because if it is Clockwork versus Nature's Prophet as the top lane, as in the matchup, and then aggressive tri-lane with a Nyx and Rubik on the bottom lane, then it wouldn't be too shabby. It wouldn't be too shabby. As far as, like, Mousesports goes, because once you get... Like, you'll have to get, like, a stout shield, maybe even a poor man shield, and pull him a couple of extra consumables for the Clockwork Goblin. And once the phase boots come up for Nature's Prophet, he'll just zone Clockwork out of the lane. He'll just push him out, and Koitva has done it many, many times with that Nature's Prophet. But we're going to finish up all our bans now, so every single support hero that Keita would think about has been removed. So SD, Visage, as well as the Bane, taken away from Mousesports. They've still got a couple of other options. Lashrak is also still in the pool as well. So they do still have another AoE stunner. Same with Jakiro. Chikiro is also available. Zizou, by the way, should be taking up the supporter role. That's the normal role that that Sin would do, so he'll go into that kind of role just to clean up the air a little bit. But yeah, so last pickups. Reserve time. I'm also asking quite for like where the hell everyone disappeared to. Find out what's going on. All right, so what's our pickup quote for? Stop answering me in draft. I can see it writing to me right now. Oh. Well, that's not an answer I was really expecting. That wasn't an answer I was expecting. They're actually watching Alex scrim, is what they're doing. Not quite sure why they have to, like, DC out. Oh, they will have to actually DC out so they can watch their TV and then they'll reconnect themselves back in again. Yeah, and they're all coming back in again. Well done. Well done. There's another track pickup I was talking about. That's it. You can't ban out all the support heroes. And he still finds nice synergy with the Magnus. And if they need to, they can run that Latrak. It's just the support with Nature's Prophet in the jungle. I doubt it, though. That's not really the way Mousesports have been playing their lineup of late. But Latrak pickup with a gyro slow and a Magnus. They'll probably still look for one more. And they might even get greedy with this. Like, you got Latrak and Gyro. Black loves his Gyro. But at the same point, like, Keita Gaming, they've got some decent initiation. But as far as, like, the early initiation, we haven't seen out all the heroes just yet. They've still got another two heroes to go. And Koitfa might even think about putting that Gyro into a support role. And I say Gyro in support role, which is almost blasphemous when you talk about Mousesports. Because Black and Fader play an amazing Gyro. But if you put him into a support role, you can then run an Alchemist. And then they'll win the split push, farm battle, and just all that kind of jazz. Keita Gaming won't want to initiate into both the Gyro and Alatrak. Both can push out the Nyx as well as the Rubick from the lane. But then you got no real proper setup as far as like a stunner goes. But we'll have to wait and see what Koitfa wants. Keita Gaming is their choice right now. Mid solo as well as number one position. So one and two slots to be filled. That's what they've got to choose, and they've got no extra time left. 8 seconds to make a decision. Up against the Magnus, Puck would be an obvious choice. Queen of Pain as well. And they go with a Kunkka. We come back for the Kunkka. The SD is gone though, so it's going to be a Rubick and Kunkka Nyx together. This is an aggressive tri lane on bottom. This most definitely is an aggressive tri lane on bottom. Unless they want to try and run defensive with a Rubick and a Nyx, which makes a little sense. But they're going to be pulling pretty damn hard. They've got to find so much experience and find it so quickly, because they won't get any kind of other advantage. Like pushing up the tower on the top lane, it's not going to happen. Because Nature's Prophet will be able to hold them off. Sack the top lane, start in the jungle, be up to level 6, and by the time the Keita game will want to push in, pop that ulti once and that push is gone. There's no stability in the push lineup for Keita. This is a pure initiation ganking kind of lineup, where Mousesports have a blend of team fight control, pushing power, and split push through their four heroes. And SK will be the final pickup. Funny enough, Cinderin's hero. it's the last one. So Latrak and SK. So we add another team fight presence, and we also add another pushing presence. I really like the dynamicness of the Mousesports lineup. They cover basically every single base. The only one which is iffy is the physical DPS one. And that comes off as like a question thing because of Gyro needing farm to have that physical DPS. If he just goes like straight BKB, he'll also be having a great time because Keita Gaming have nothing to go through that. They have absolutely... they got Clockwork ulti, sorry. That will add this done. And SF is the final pickup. So SF versus Mag in mid. Bensa will take up the role as the SF. Which I'm actually not quite sure about because I think Saiso... Yeah, last time I cast Keita Gaming, it was Saiso that ran the mid lane. But yeah, we'll see where they're going to end up. We're going to get into game number one right now. Reminder too for the guys who are tuning in, if you are looking for a Dota TV ticket, you will not find one until tonight. It's meant to be released with the patch that comes out this evening for the main Dota 2 client. It was meant to come with the patch last night, but there was some issues with something surrounding the ticket. And I'm pretty sure, I didn't actually ask what the issue was, I probably should have done that. But if I was to gander a guess, I would say it's something to do with the
5 seconds remaining.
With the perk that comes with the ticket. Perk. I like perk. Perk is a lot better word for that. Yeah, the perk that comes with the ticket. So definitely check it out. But all the defense games from all previous days for the group stage so far, they will all be put into the Dota TV ticket. So we'll submit all the match IDs and Valve will manually add them in there. So if you are looking to have all your defense games put into one nice little place for you to watch, then the defense ticket is the place to go. But for now, everyone tuning in on Dota TV, it is free. It is free for everybody. No one has to pay anything and they get to enjoy Dota TV. The only thing you have to do is search and find the game. That's all you got to do. Seems pretty easy. Seems pretty easy. But it's actually quite difficult. Just look for the one that everyone should be watching. Because right now it looks like all the competitive games are done for the night. With the Night Owls, with the last tournament running at this time of the evening. But we'll have some good times together, peoples. We'll have some good times together. We'll also remember to come back tomorrow. We've got more action coming up tomorrow and on Sunday. I know I went through the list earlier on tonight about what's coming up tomorrow, but quickly to go through it, VP versus IC Couple Stars tomorrow at 15 CEST, Next.KZ versus Fnatic, the Mouse versus RoX.KIS, Fnatic versus IC Cup, and then coming up on Sunday, Absolute Legends will play up against Next.KZ, and then a Na'Vi doubleheader. They go up against Keita to start with, and then they will go up against Team Empire. And, well, I'm hoping Team Empire... I'm actually hoping they do really well. I'm really hoping they do well. And then the last game of the night, we have Mousesports versus Team Empire. And that almost concludes every game from Group A and B. That's right. We actually finished the group stage in 1 week. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. Fnatic versus AL is the only game which has been postponed, so we'll probably be running that before one of the EMSs on Monday and Tuesday. And then coming up next week, we'll have the games from Group C and Group D starting on Wednesday. So if you haven't checked out the groups, go to the-defense.com and you'll see the details there. But the teams which are highlighting in it, the Alliance, DD.DOTA, Evil Geniuses, Team Liquid, Team Dignitas, a lot of teams, and Kaipi, they're the three big-seeded teams. Arctic Gaming and 4FC, they kind of got the wildcard invites, and then Z-Rage and Lions Pride, the boys that came through the qualifiers. And we wish them all the best of luck. And that'll be starting up Wednesday next week. You can follow it all there. As well as, of course, the Raycall EMS 1 coverage, which comes out here. And a couple of other tournaments. EIZO Cup will be returning. If you didn't see it, we had ourselves a little bit of fun at the end of the last one. If you beat me solo mid, you ended up winning a really cool EIZO monitor. Funnily enough, I won, peoples. That right, I won on one solo mid, and I won. But it's very easy to sign up. And we're going to keep doing that. We're going to keep doing that until someone beats me. And the consolation prize is a free copy of Bioshock. Infinite, that is. Because we're giving them away everywhere. So much. All right, let's check out our lanes. So, a little bit wrong about our lanes. And, technically I was actually right about our lanes because I corrected myself. CYSO will be taking up that mid-solo Kunkka. And it looks like he is built... A little bit of extra strength, but he's definitely built to pick up that bottle and then go into Magic Wand Urn. Puts on our top lane, Bensa. Of course, you want to give him some safe lane to farm up that SF. Because once he starts getting out of control, I'm not quite sure if Mousesports will have enough to lock him down. And then you've got Rubick as well as Nyx Assassin. So they're going to be on a pool job right now. And then Phloxpox, we give him all the best of luck on the bottom lane as he's going up against Black's Gyrocopter. Pass will be on the SK, and that puts our stand-in Zizu. He'll be over on the Lashrak into the middle lane. Fader for the Magnus for the solo mid. Bottle Rush as normal. And, of course, he lets the range creep through a little bit faster. That way it's easy to bring down. A lot of people like to do this because the range creep will die quicker. As you can see, like, he's got less life points. And it's also one of those things where you have the range creep at the back and your creep wave gets more momentum because you've got this continuous damage without having to lose life points. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. That's why when you get, like, a couple of range creeps stacking up and you want to push down towers, it's a lot more effective because you just have your meat shields and you have your damage dealers at the back. But welcome to the battle of CS in the middle lane. Kind of want to watch that one a little bit closer, but we're still going to say Quitva. There he is. Inside the jungle. Farming up as the Nature's Prophet. And Floxpox trying to stay close enough to get 1 point of experience. And he hasn't got 1 point just yet. He's on the edge of the experience line. And he got 62 points. Awesome. Objective achieved. Objective achieved. Take a little bit of extra damage, but objective is achieved. Well, a little bit of an early pull there. Yeah, he had to use telekinesis to hold him there. That was the only way he would keep the aggro. And because the Radiant creep wave's up too, they're going to lose one of the range creeps to that creep wave. But it does allow them to farm up the Satter camp at least, so there is some kind of levels coming their way. They're looking for level 2 before they gank. I don't think they're going to really reach it though. But the two of them, the Satter going down. They get close, but they won't actually reach it. They'll need to do another pull through if they want to get that level 2. But they've got a smoke and they want to kill something. So it's very, very obvious what they want to attempt. Oh, actually, they might... Satter? No, it's not going to be able to tick him over. Oh yeah, it is. Only just though. Only just. 5 HP, 5 experience points over for both of them. Nyx Assassin still hasn't leveled up a single ability just yet. Waits for a double damage rune. No one's on the top lane. Propus making no attempt to go up there. And Quitva doesn't need to. As I said, he's just going to farm up inside the jungle. He's looking for levels. That's the major thing. Hand of Midas to come up, that's fantastic. But he wants his level 6 and 2 points, maybe 3 points up in trees. This is actually probably the worst thing that could happen to Benz's creep wave right now. He's pushed out too far. Farming underneath that tower is never a fun thing to do. And holds his crit. Like, it just takes out the balance a little bit. There's no damage to the tower whatsoever. Didn't even land a single hit because he wasn't looking for that. Oh, Fader. Nice cure. You got to keep that body block going on Kunkus, who has to take a little bit more damage from the tower. Shockwave damage. Oh, that's not enough. 69 HP and then bottle charging up. Didn't cost Fader too much. These bottles now arriving. At the same time, Edict damage. Looking to bring down that tower. Fortunately for Lashrak, he started taking a little bit too much damage from that tower, but the aggro was pulled off him. And Clockwork again trying to get a little bit closer, but he's got rockets and he's got cogs. There's nothing to work with. And Black comes in close, he's just going to go full rocket barrage on him. Even with Flat Cannon so he can harass him from range. That's going to be to get rid of the creep wave too. Flat Cannon has to... Rocket Barrage means he has to come in just that little bit too close. Where Flat Cannon means he can keep his distance a little bit more. SK. The Dire side. I think he just showed himself quickly. The pings most definitely came out. So Clockwork's just trying to hang himself back a little bit further. But there's a catapult coming in the next push. And this will be the tower to go down. There is no doubt about it. And when the creep wave goes in, SK will also dive it. Clarity gets cancelled off, that's frustrating. But he got most of it off. Yeah, and there goes Black into a rocket barrage. He's getting impatient. SK's wasting too much time on this bottom lane, just waiting for him. While Mag and Kunkka just keep going at it. I think nautical. And they'll look to the tier 1 tower now. New creep wave arrives. Dire 1's not there fast enough. And now SK can dive. But he has a level 2 Barrow Strike, and Floxbox, he went to a corner. Prophet's going to TP in as well, and Quitva says hello. He doesn't have a Sprout. He's got no mana. He just TP'd in there looking for a body block out. And unsuccessful. But the tower goes down nonetheless, so... He comes out of the jungle. Doesn't waste too much time. Might buy a TP scroll and go back to base, but he's got no mana whatsoever. His Trina is still looking for extra money for him. He's so close to his hand of mice, he won't want to spend the cash. And because of this, it's a little bit of time he lost, but this push is actually coming a little bit sooner than I thought on the top lane. Catapult came in, they managed to double up their creep wave. Or you see those three range creeps plus a siege creep. So they can do a lot of damage to this top lane. And SF, he can just nuke through these creep waves. So SK is the one that's forced to come onto the top lane. Of course, he can't just hide inside the sandstorm. Classic SKs. Where people didn't have like a targeted stun SF, in this case, will just start raising on the spot he's sitting. But there's going to be some good levels right now for Pass. And he'll be able to control this lane up pretty nicely. He's not a massive fan of farming this close on the tower. Trying to get those last hits still becomes a lot more of a challenge for him. SF's kind of wanting to get back down here so he can find these last hits too. He wants the last hits denied and just soak up those souls. Even though at this point he is maxed. Only got 2 points up in the Necromastery. In fact, where's his other point? He's got 3 and 2. And then plus five, but the plus five makes sense. Now there we go. Third point now up in Necromastery. There's no point having a level one ultimate. It's going to get a bit of a rework at the next patch, but still. Having that extra right-click damage just, like, storing up with all these souls is so much more important. Because the ultimate gets stronger with the more souls, so you know what you're going to max up anyway. And right now, SF, as well as Black, they're keeping pretty close. Like, Benza, as well as, my bad. RP being used, ship being used, SK used nothing, and they get a kill in the middle lane. And it goes the way of Mousesports onto the Kunkka. Difficult hero to try and escape. He has no escape mechanism, that's the reason why most of the time he's put as a dual lane in that middle lane. As opposed to going just this solo, but he probably thought he was going to be okay considering, like, well, it's just another melee hero. It's a melee hero with RP. Like, ship is good for team fights, but one-on-one, like, landing that stun and getting the opportunity, that's a lot more difficult. By the way, guys, I hope you're drinking. Shout out to people who are playing the TobiWan drinking game. It's a good drinking game. It's a good drinking game. Fader. Invis room, but no RP, but still with a skewer and shockwave, you do enough damage with in combination with pass. They can get themselves a kill, but Benz has already, like, realized this hero's missing. Scissors on the run right now. Steph style. It's right and close behind him. Flox goes into the little battery assault. There's a cooldown coming in from Black. Nice Barrow strike. Nyx assassin already on the sidelines. Ruby's getting killed off by just this range creep, but Black finally gets that last little flat cannon hit in. Flox cogs. Push him back. Pass. He wants to cut through the tree lines. Like, please, just use your sprout. Yeah, I mean, use your call. Get rid of these guys. Or is he? No. Radiant's no. Middle tower is under attack. He has time to buy a bottle, a stick. They don't know where he went. They honestly don't know where he went. He's going to get out of here. He's got boot movement speed, and it is highly unlikely that Black will have anything to do with it. He just hid on the other side of the tree, under the cover of nighttime. But he's about to be spotted. Koifa's farming. Oh, he just moved back at the wrong time. They wouldn't even realize he left the bottom, and he finds a regeneration rune. Luckiest clockwork in the map. Is he on the clockwork in the map? Line's being drawn to go middle lane now. Next assassin's in the neighborhood. Fader. Oh, he got the RP. But a follow-up stun very quickly there by Steph Style. And now in comes Rubik. Picks up Fader, so we can't skewer him back out again. Spy Campus also makes it a little bit more difficult. In comes Koifa. Pass. Looking for another stun. CYSO, he got pushed up to the high ground. There's your double Burrow strike. Actually, he got a triple on that one. Analyst Shrek follow-up. There's still no kills coming off. Frigo Lee goes down to 1 HP. Pass wants him. The Tauren is there. He Burrow strikes through. Kunkka will go down in this. And there's more support coming in. The clockwork, finally he actually meets up with the rest of Mousesports lineup. Eating damage from Lashrak ensures the kill. We go 6-1. And Keita Gaming living life very much on the edge, especially the Rubik. A 1 HP escape, you count your lucky stars that day. You count definitely your lucky stars that day. And Black, would you believe it, back into farming, gonna go straight for a BKB. As we said before, there's nothing that Keita have that goes through a BKB as far as, like, stopping him from attacking. So he'll go the BKB, then go into his casual Yasha. Might just complete the mana style, but considering he's going up against an SF and a Kunkka, I got a feeling that more than likely he'll just skip the mana style. Go into a hood, a helm, or Domino, sorry, and then into a butterfly. Just look for that extra damage and lifesteal and stay ability during the fights. So if he does have to man fight up against the SF, he can do so. Because SF at this point, building into a Shadow Blade, already has the Claymore up and running. He's already back up here, looking for more souls. But he's maxed. So 28. Another level maybe would help him out. He did put 1 point into his level, into his ultimate. Black's given so much space in this bottom lane. But it doesn't matter though. Like, SF's still finding his space. Let's just pull through what's happening with the creep waves too, so if anyone tries to come to this top lane to try and find the farm, they'll instantly regret it. Fader, pass, and the stand-in Zizu. Gonna stay with the rest of the Mousesports lineup. They look for an opening. Observer and Sentry of the Radiant side. So not gonna be revealed from this one, but Stevstar, that award on the high ground really helps him out. There we go. Instantly see him walk up the hill and say, this isn't worth it. Two on the top lane though. SF, Benz has gotta get back. Almost worth the TP if he's gonna be too late. That haste rune from Magnus. He walks fast, he can get the up. Whoa! Picked up, throwing down, Shockwave well off target. That almost looked like a return, like a shift click attempt. Run. And Coin back into his farm. He's pretty close to his Shadow Blade as well. Now he's running that hand of Myers, so he's finding his experience. It's what we're talking about when you run a Nature's Prophet, you just sack the top lane. Doesn't care about the top lane. Tier 1 tower goes down, not a problem at all. Tier 2 tower remains up, that's fine. Means people aren't going to be attacking on your base all of a sudden. Fader. Just looking for a kill on the top lane. He knows Frig Elite's up here. There's a Sentry Ward looking for it. Now the Observer Ward's also going to see Nyx. Oh, Baru! Pass attempted. Fake. Vroom, vroom, vroom. Now into the middle lane. Koyva's going to get ganked. Clockwork. Nice latch on. Cogs will hold him there, which means it's a guaranteed torrent. And Flockfox and Koyva, they fight it out. In comes a skewer from Fader. And Flockfox going to go down. Get away from the ship. It's going to fly in. Koyva, he runs fast enough away. RP, it's their fourth time tonight that the RP has hit absolutely jack all. Lashrak looking for a stun. Up to the higher ground. Caesar actually moving nicely here. Tidebringer attack. Really playing around with Fader on the movements. The strike wanted the stun. It would have been enough. Maybe then follow up with a little bit more like straight on damage, but took its sweet ass time and couldn't really get it right. Fader was able to afford up a blink dagger now on the courier and also finds an invis rune to boot to bottle up. So CYSO already brings the courier out to himself. He needs to send it back again. Courier have anything on it? There's phase boots. So phase boots, turn the courier around, bottle as well. Shadow Blade is up for Benzer. The Prophet already bouncing around, so maybe under a little bit more pressure from that Nature's Prophet, who also now 100% has his Shadow Blade. And with his Hand of Myers continuously triggering off, he's finding some really, really fast levels. Four top levels, level 10. Three of them are Mousesports players. And then you have the SK. The lowest level for the Radiant side is level 6, and you got 2 5s over on Keita. Both the Nyx Assassin who doesn't have ulti and Rubick who doesn't have ulti. So there's no big steals, there's no Vendetta initiations, they haven't come for a 14 minute window right now. And it might last longer if this pressure keeps up. Pass as well as Koyva, there's create an army and push through that top lane. And this is going to be the second tier 1 town to take a fall in favor of Mousesports. At the same time, there's a blink skewer. In a bit off target. Yeah, with the phase boots as well that pop off from CYSO, he does have that extra little bit of like fancy toe work to get himself away from that. Gonna be quick, but he can move a little bit faster. So won't always get caught in his heels. Yeah, there's Nature's Prophet Shadow Blade. And as he just builds straight into treads as well. Don't really think he wants to go into phase boots. Yeah, I'm straight back out to farming in the lane. I'll be looking to something else. Something a little bit more pushy and farmy. Black has his BKB, but he's about to die. He's too low on life. Oh, first raise missed. That was the wrong range. He meant to go for medium and he missed. And Clockwork also going to miss his ulti. Black, he's just trying to fancy footwork this one out. Now in comes Fader. RP's available, Blink Dagger as well. I'm surprised he didn't just blink himself in. And now there's 3 heroes caught. If he skewers into this one right now, this next mark spot wants to hold him there. Epicenter comes off from the SK. It's a little enough damage. There you go. Skewer, RP. Ship flies out over the top. Misses everything but Fader. Benz has got all the space in the world to keep this raise going. A nice double Burrow Strike. Try to turn around Phlox Blocks. With that last stack from Koyfer, he'll take it. But now he doesn't have Shadow Blade. Needs to run Invis. What was stolen? Oh, Wrath of Nature. Throw it and keep vision. There it goes. Yes, he waited till he saw the vision on him. And Benzer gets a triple kill. That instant burst damage at the start. It's a really nice ultimate to steal. 4 heroes from Mousesports. Pushing up the daisies. Black is still capable of buying up his BKB after dying just because he had so much farm at the very, very start. But that was a huge fight for Keita to win. Lifesteal coming the way of Bensa. Might be looking at stacking up right now and getting that helm with the Dominator up and running. With this last Wilkin camp, he'll have enough. And of course, by doing this kind of farm, he restricts Black from doing the same thing. So what Black was doing when he caught him out. And instantly Coinfus back up again. He goes, you know what? Hanamitis back in. Also notice too the creep he's ended up taking. Takes one of the smaller creeps. Money is more important to him than levels right now. And that's 100% right. He's got 4 points up in the Nature's Call. He's got 4 points up in the Teleportation. And 2 points up in Ultimate. Level 16 Ultimate. It's going to be a little bit better. But it's not the be-all, end-all of Alakazam. Right now he wants gold. He wants items. That's the focus of an Aegis Prophet when he hits this point of the game. His ultimate does damage during the team fight, and level 16 will come in time. No point trying to push it out. Extra TP support's coming in, so now Mousesports, 5 men Dota time. The sentry wall is down for the Dire side, just behind the tower, so no one can jump in behind it. So if Fader comes down this hill, he will be revealed. In fact, yep, now he's 100% revealed. But the mid tower's already gone down. Gyro takes it out, so Black feels very, very happy about life, universe, and everything. And Fader, he still wants blood. Blink him. RP on two. He can skewer them out. Clockwork latches, but then he gets caught with him. SK actually burrow strike through them into the sandstorm, but there's still a sentry ward revealing off pass. So Benzer comes in. He's now dominating. Look at the attack coming off here from the SF with the 2 points in the presence of the Dark Lord. These two supports just have no armor. And then no life points. And with a Mask of Manners, he attacks hard and he attacks really, really fast. So that's what Bensa brought up. It wasn't this helm to slow farm. It's a, I want to kill crap and I want to do it now. 5-0-1. That's what they're looking at right now. And we've got two candidates for the Melk Award. Three, in fact. One death, two deaths, three deaths. Absolutely nothing. SF can carry this game completely. He's got a fantastic start. If he gets a BKB up next, yeah, there's the Mithril Hammer. This could also go two ways. This could definitely go two ways. You go Mithril Hammer to start with, it's already showing he wants to do more and more damage. So he's got two options with this. One, he goes the BKB. He goes the safe route. He says, okay, I gotta make sure I don't get stunned, I don't get controlled. Or he can say, well, I've already got so much space which has been made by all my other supports, why don't I just go a Desolator? And just start destroying everything. It's not the new Desolator with the change. We're giving you like the extra negative armor. It's the old Desolator, but with a Shadow Blade and Vendetta. And they found an easy kill. Zizu's dead. See that hit coming off from the Shadow Blade. Of course, that was also reworked too with the extra damage when it hits. And then straight down the bottom lane. He wants to go on Black. Even with a BKB, you can't block the physical damage. Look at that movement from Bensa. He's moving beautifully, but then Dust in, he turns around on Coifa, and that ulti will pop off, and Coifa, he can't kill a Black. Inside the BKB, that Rocket Barrage does nothing. Stev style, he's wanting a kill. Spike Carapace holds pass out, and he follows up with a stun. He's got a rocket on his tail. That's a big death for the SF. And that is reason enough that he's actually got to get a BKB. All the confidence in the world. Actually, with a Desolator, he would have killed off the Gyro before anyone came in. With the Desolator. Even with Coin for TPing himself in. Couldn't hide inside the Shadow Blade. Dust popped off from Nature's Prophet, so he's feeling great about life. That's the first death now for the SF. And puts Gyro higher on the net worth board now. About 800 gold. And Black does go for a little bit more stand. So Helm with the Dominator for him. Oh, he's already seeing a creep moving over there. Nope. Needs a new creep. Finding nothing but mud golems doesn't help him. Fader's having all the help he needs. He's got the items he basically needs to fight. Blink Dagger. As well as having his Arcane Boots. Yeah. This is the reason why. Observer Ward was watching Floxpox move his positioning so he could actually hook himself in. That's a really nice ward up the hill. Shockwave and Empower. And it's the easiest farm for Magnus. SK also managed to pick up one. He actually put 1 point up into the caustic finale. Not something all SKs want to do all the time, because it does add a little bit more push to the lane. But sometimes just having that extra 90 damage in the middle of a team fight is worth it, because it comes in a hero as well. Dust goes on the top lane. Koifa, he wants this kill. X marks spot, Tauren as well. Oh, what a time for Fader to blink himself in, but the stun is there on Benza. He goes down instantly. The ship will fly out in Zizu, but doesn't matter. Kunker already retreated back out to safety. And Steph style, he's going to use his Vendetta to scan out for Floxpox. Can't get himself too caught out. Burrow Strike goes on Frigo lead. Into the Sandstorm then. Sentry Ward goes down. So pass initiated on. Held, stunned, and destroyed. That's still an SF for an SK. With a lot of TP scrolls also being used by the Dioside. So not really worth it. Especially when Nature's Prophet then does this. Just goes straight back into his jungle. Pops the Hand of Midas. Starts farming up. In fact, doesn't even start farming up. He just uses it for the Hand of Midas. And then comes into gank up the middle lane. Double RP, skewered down, look for the follow-up Sprout. In fact, he was almost about to do it. He's waiting for the right time to attack. Now he comes out. They go, okay, maybe I should start attacking now. Maybe a torrent from Kunker. He throws the ship. He throws a big ship as well, and it hits. Clockwork takes a double kill. Kunker takes the Lashrak. Mousesports lose so much in that middle lane because they couldn't decide who they want to finish off. And Keita, they're showing you why they're 2-0 in this group. They are, at this point, the number one ranked team in Group A of the defense. They're playing wonderfully coordinated Dota. Black wants to stop him. In he comes, flat cannon. That's going to be a lot of damage. Kunker doesn't have his invis just yet. And now Floxpox, well, it's got the advantage that those cogs are still doing its job. But the kill is still there for the SK. It's getting closer and closer to having that blink dagger. And Kieta weren't able to bring down that T1 tower in the middle lane. The tower advantage still goes heavily the way of the Dire side. As Blank goes back into his farming. Had an easy stack up. Now up to 3.7k. And about to become about 4,000 gold at the end of his farming here. Malfader moves to the top lane. Invis room for him. Koitva. Little do they know. Shadowblade TP out. Very smartly done. Koiva was looking for him. He thought he was still down in that side shop, but SF made the wise choice and moved before he TP'd. And now is Kunker. The invis scouting, the invis movement. Everyone is looking for the positional advantage to win this game. Everybody's looking for it. Did that BKB? Yeah, Benza, he has admitted it. In fact, he cannot go a Desolator. He's going BKB. Sentry Ward, what a timing for pass. He could have thrown that at a better time. He sees two of them. He's going to Burrow Strike out. He goes through two of them. X marks the spot. He'll go around everywhere, but Koifa now going to come his way in. The Tauren will hit, but Black, it's a call down. It's going to hit on three. No, it only hits on two, but the flat cannon damage. He takes out the Rubik. Back over. Fader skewers out Flockbox out of his own cogs and keeps on going in. Lashrak with a stump, and they just prophesied the one last hit. Stevstar trying to kill off Fader, and now SF winds up the oldie. No one was really in range for that one, and Fader, three man the RP. SF oldie does pop at the end of it. Koifa takes a triple kill out of all of that as well. SF's oldie only popped because he was dead. Expend all those souls, down to 18 in fact. And all of Keita. Mousesports might have a horrible fight, but Keita, they just had the worst one. Lashrak for 5 was the trade-off. And Pass will check out. No, he's just walking past Roshan. No one wants it just yet. Quaver's having too much fun on his split push. Faye Bolt will just bounce through as many of them as possible, but also surprising Ruby didn't try and steal an ability just then. He could have stolen trees. Instead, he came in and decided to Faye Bolt instead. Always, it's kind of sad when Rubik can steal an ability and he has none. Always sad. It's like watching a Hand of Mice that hasn't been used. Here's our build from Gyro. So it's exactly as predicted for the Gyro. BKB. Go up with the lifesteal. And then go into the butterfly. No other reason to go anything else. It's the way he wants to build. He can build the Monkey King bar up a little bit later. And Benza. Actually, we got Prophet already with his Scythe of Ice 25 minutes in. Considering that triple kill on the bottom lane would give him a nice boost up. Only one person now in possible of Malk Award, and that's Frigga Elite. He'll look for the opening to die multiple times, 20 times in total. Yeah, there's that Gyro Butterfly. So Gyro Butterfly is now on him. Well, they smoke up instantly and want to make a move. Koifa just a little bit further behind. You'll see that TPing towards the top lane. They said, no, guys, just stay with him. He just broke smoke. Not really sure why they're doing that, though. Aggressive ward, Benser, Fader. He could RP. Mist-stun already coming out from pass, so he can't do his combo. He blinked himself away, and already the Lashrak goes down. The boat has been thrown, however. Black wants to keep chasing on Flopbox, and now he pops the BKB. Devstar was about to throw out his impale, but it's not going to be anywhere near enough. They're going to accept the fact that Clockwork is dead right now. It's a one-for-one trade. But that's also the mech for Keita gone. Not what they want to have happen. Shadow Blade is up on Fader. I love this. Shadow Blade up on Fader. Attacks. Shockwave. Talking his pickup. Is he going to skewer it? Yeah, he's going to skewer it. And then blinks himself back down again. And then stolen the skewer. Pulls him up to the high ground. The Shockwave will still get the kill for Fader. Meanwhile, over at the Conker. He's on the run from past. 1 second. 1 second. Burrow Strike hits. Which means Rocker Barrage finishes the job. Benser coming in with the Shadow Blade. Have they got vision here? They got a gem on pass. Dyer's middle tower. I'm guessing SF didn't know that when he came in as aggressively as he did. And when they turned like that, he would have instantly had some kind of indication. Now he's hexed up. Koifa pops the ultimate. Lashrak was looking for the follow-up stun. In comes Fader. RP doesn't need it. He just keeps using his skewer. Now the BKB pops from Benser. Then there's reason to use the RP. Puts down the Sprout. Nice done by Koifa. Had to do that on the ground just then. But it's Black that takes the double kill. With a flat cannon, they already start up on the tier 3 tower now in the mid. That was a really, like, nice play by Koifa. When someone's inside BKB, you can't cast a Sprout on them. You've got to cast it on the ground itself. And not an easy task to do. A little bit easier though when the SF's not moving as much. But now that's mid-racks. They probably won't rotate into the bottom lane, but what they will do is split push it out and then think about Roshan and Keita. They gotta think about how they can get themselves back inside this game because they have lost... Okay, they've lost a lot of control. They have lost a lot of control and they just called GG. 28 minutes and we get the GG call coming up from Keita. They say this is enough for us. This game is over. There is no more. So Mousesports will take the first game here. And Keita's winning streak comes to an end. They will go 2-1. They are leveled now with Mousesports in that number one position. The team that takes this next game will take the number one spot in Group A. For the moment. For the moment. Every team has four games to play out. That is, every team has four games to play out. There is no other way to evade it. Unstoppable. Wow, really, Black? He's having a lot of fun by himself. I want the picturesque end view. Hence, we're going to stay on SK for the moment. But yeah, everyone plays four games. Mousesports, this is their second. This is their second set. And as far as Keita, so also their second set. But Keita, they had a really, like, amazing game. The fact they managed to go 2-0 against RoX.KIS. Like, I feel so chuffed about that one. The fact that by doing such a thing, they pushed both Na'Vi and Mousesports, and the grid has actually updated for me. So they pushed both Na'Vi and Mousesports into that third position. But with this game, it changes things, of course. Four games for each team. That's what they've got to get themselves seated in this group stage. The $25,000 off for grabs and get themselves into the playoffs. A lot of pressure on every single one of these games. Stay tuned. We'll be returning in just a couple of moments' time with our... It is our last game of the night. Best of threes, we don't have them. We do two-game series, which means you know exactly how long the Dota will last. We'll be back for our last game.
I said good day, sir!